Hey everyone, welcome to another video. This video is gonna be my May Shop My Stash. So I'm gonna be updating you on my Shop My Stash from April, and then I'm gonna show you all the new products that I chose out for the coming month. So let's get right into the video. So if you haven't been on my channel before, my name is Marley and I love making YouTube videos about makeup and beauty. I love doing looks, swatches, reviews, will I buy it videos, all those kinds of things. So if that sounds good to you, then don't forget to subscribe. I usually upload about 2 to 3 videos a week and would love to see you again on my channel. So yeah, let's start with everything that I chose out for the month of April. I have to say this month really flew by. I also kept it a little bit shorter than the last time. The last time I was a little bit late with uploading my Shop My Stash. So I kept this one a bit shorter because I do want to keep it a little bit at the beginning of the month. So I had a bit less time to play with this product, but I feel like most of them I used enough. There's just one product that I didn't use. So let's start with the cheeks. First up, I chose this Sunbeam highlighter from H&M. And it had been a long time since I last wore this. This is really like my summer, spring, summer highlighter. So I remembered that I really liked it, but I didn't remember exactly how it looked on me. And to my surprise, it looked a bit lighter, and I feel like I can get away with it more easily as a highlighter than I actually expected. So I actually really enjoyed wearing this one more on the cheekbones as well. I don't really have to use this as a blush topper. It's like light and peachy enough for me to just use it as a highlighter. So that's something I really enjoyed discovering again. So I'm definitely excited to wear this one more. Then I chose this Nabla highlighter in the shade Privilege from the Skin Glazing line. I grabbed for this so many times. I think I wore this like half of the month. Okay, maybe that's not true, but at least I wore this a lot of times. I also have my Project Pen highlighters. Those I also use a lot, but this one I grabbed for so many times. This is just such a favorite. I really love wearing this one. It has such a beautiful sheen and color. And this Shop My Stash really has proven once again to me how much I love this one, because I just kept grabbing for it. Then next up, I chose this Maybelline Knockout highlighter. I chose this as kind of like a blush topper, and I used it for that. Really liked it. Felt like I could have maybe used it a bit more, but sometimes you just don't end up doing looks where a certain product really fits. And that was kind of the case with this one. I really loved wearing it when I did, but I didn't really wear it like a lot. But this is just such a beautiful highlighter, such a beautiful blush topper. Then I also chose this MAC Room to Bloom highlighter from the Black Cherry collection. Actually reached for this quite a lot, really enjoy it. When I reviewed it, it was kind of like in my good category, but I feel like I'm starting to like it even more and more. I like this color. I just really like this color a lot. I just feel like it's really flattering, and I just love the amount of sheen this gives without being glittery or without being really highlightery and icy. I just really love this color and this effect, and I really enjoyed grabbing for this one. I actually use this quite a lot. Then the Hourglass highlighter in Sublime Flush. I'm actually wearing this one right now as well. Really enjoyed wearing this one. I grabbed for this one a couple of times. It's just a really nice kind of light corally shade with a bit of a cool tone sheen. This is really something that is just so easy to throw on. It really like smooths out the skin, makes it look so much better. And therefore I really, really enjoyed wearing this one. I really like this one. Then next up, I chose out another H&M highlighter. This one is in the shade Aurora Blush. I only wore this once. I feel like I could have worn it more, but it just didn't happen. It's also not the easiest highlighter to wear because it's so colorful. It's like a warm lilac, but it's so beautiful. I definitely want to use this again soon. I also feel like this looks just a little bit better when I just have a bit of a tan. So probably I'm gonna put this back in my Shop My Stash sometime soon. I liked wearing it that one time, but I just feel like I didn't give it the love it deserves. But sometimes that happens. Then this blush palette by Sleek, I actually chose to try it to see if I actually wanted to keep this. It's pretty old in my collection. I never really reached for it a lot. And I've bought so many beautiful blushes. I have so many beautiful new blushes. And I wanted to see if I would ever grab for this one. And I think the answer is no. I tried this one and I just feel like a lilac blush looks weird on me. In theory, I like a lilac blush, but in practice, when I apply it, it just looks a bit odd. I feel like maybe then it should be a little bit darker than this, or a little bit more of a warm lilac. Maybe then it would work. And then this warm pink blush, that was actually what it was about for me. I wanted to see if I wanted to keep that one in my collection. It's so bright, it's so pigmented. You just it's just so pigmented that you can't really blend it out. I think this would be perfect if you have like a deep skin tone and you want to wear a bright pink blush. But on me, it looked so kind of cakey and makeup-y and too made up and unnatural. And I just didn't love it. I couldn't really blend it out. And it kind of grabbed onto certain parts of the skin. And I think if I would want to make this work, then I would have to be like really careful. And I don't really feel like putting in that work. I'd rather buy a new blush that's a bit less pigmented, easier to work with, that also isn't this old and isn't in this palette, that is just taking up space in my collection. I actually decided that I'm gonna declutter this. This is the moment. This is gonna go in the bin. I'm not even gonna keep this around for like my next declutter or anything, because I just know I'm not gonna use this anymore. Then let's move on to the lip products. First up, I chose this A La Plage Luster Lipstick by MAC. This is kind of like a cool toned bronze, really sheer. It has a beautiful shine. It has like really, really fine shimmer in there, but it doesn't look extremely shimmery on the lips. I think it's a really flattering color. This is from a limited edition from last year. I really enjoyed wearing this one. I just think this is such an unexpected shade. Something that I wouldn't have expected to work so well, but I really love this. And I'm kind of thinking I should check out some other luster lipsticks. Maybe there are some other shades I would also like in this formula. I just feel like this is my thing right now. A little bit sheer, a little bit shiny. I like this one. Next up, I chose the shade 85 from the Sephora Cream Lip Stains. Really enjoyed wearing this one. It's kind of like a brighter pink nude. It's really pink, but it still has some softness to it. It's really wearable for me, at least. I really like this shade on me. Really enjoyed wearing this one. Then I also chose this Crème de la Femme lipstick from MAC. I think this is in their Frost formula. I chose this to wear together with my Project Pan lipstick, and I did. And I really enjoy this particular shade. I think it's really flattering on me. I just really love wearing pinks. Then I also chose this Nabla Close Up Lip Shaper in the shade 1. Because I feel like I should wear it more, and I wore it like 2 times. I'm also wearing it today. It's just that this doesn't do a lot for my lips because it's just a bit too light for me. I feel like my lips are just slightly more pigmented than this, and then it just feels a little bit weird. It doesn't give me the definition that I want. I really like the formula. I just don't love this color, and I maybe should have gone like one shade up, but now that I have it, I'm just gonna use it like once in a while. I don't like hate it, but my taste in lip liners is just that it's a little bit deeper than my own lip color. Then I also chose the Nabla Dreamy Creamy Liquid Lipstick in the shade Eve. It's also what I'm wearing right now. I wore this a couple of times. Really enjoy this formula. It's so nice, hydrating and creamy. Love this color. It's just really pretty. And I also chose this lip gloss by Nabla. This is a Shine Theory lip gloss in Stardust Radio. Really love this lip gloss. Really wanted to wear this, but it just didn't happen. I just didn't feel like that was a perfect look for me to use this, and I didn't end up wearing it. I didn't end up using it, and I'm just gonna be keeping this one in because I do really want to wear it. Then let's move on to the eyeshadows that I actually chose out for last month. First up, I chose this palette of single eyeshadows by Lethal Cosmetics. I didn't really do like full looks with this because I'm also trying out a bunch of single eyeshadows from other brands that are like really special shimmers, and I just basically grabbed these mattes and combined them with those shimmery eyeshadows. So I didn't use this palette on its own, but that's also kind of how I look at this palette, as a combination, as a collection of really nice matte singles that I can combine with other singles as well. So I enjoyed wearing this one, but I didn't really do a look just focusing on this one. What I do notice more and more is that these eyeshadows are really pigmented but also really powdery, so I have to be careful sometimes that it doesn't get in my eye. But for the most part, I really enjoyed using these eyeshadows. I think it's just so convenient. If you have some special shades in your collection, some special shimmers, it's so nice to have some matte eyeshadows to go with that. Then I also chose the Fame palette by ColourPop to just get into the cool tones a bit more, use some cool toned eyeshadows, and I just did a few softer cool toned looks with this one. I don't even know if I really have a picture of those because they were just like really nude, really soft, really wearable. But I do really enjoy using these eyeshadows. I really like the shimmers in here. There are some really nice mattes in here, some really nice colors, especially those more rosy mattes that have a little bit of that rosy undertone. I actually really love using because they are still cool, but they have just a little bit of a different undertone. So I really enjoyed using using this palette. Then the palette that I basically used all month and I used so many times is the Nabla Dreamy Eyeshadow Palette. I used this so many times. I just kept reaching for this, kept going into these mattes. I did a look using this one in the crease and it was so beautiful. This is just such a favorite of mine. I really love these shimmers. I think they are so pretty. They aren't like really shimmery, but they are just really opaque, really shiny. And I just love the tones of these mattes. I just kept grabbing for this one every time I wanted to do a little bit of a simple look or a bit of a soft look with like a pop of color. I just couldn't put this down this month. This is just so good. I really, really enjoy using this one. And I really feel like I knew I loved this one, but our love is like rekindled. I'm almost kind of sad that this isn't going to be in my next Shop My Stash. And I'm just now noticing that I missed a lip product. This is a Sephora cream lip stain in the shade 70. It's kind of like a rosy nude. It's leaning quite warm. It looks quite peachy on the lips. I wore this once and I really enjoyed the look. But with this one as well, I feel like I could have given it more love. I feel like I want to use it more during this time, but it's not going to be in my next Shop My Stash. But probably in the summer, I'm going to put this back in. Then the last eyeshadow palette. I also didn't really do like a full look with the Juvia's Place Wahala 2. I was planning to, but I just have so many interesting shimmers to test out. And this has just so many beautiful, colorful mattes that I could use for that. That I actually reached into this quite a lot, but I didn't do like a full dedicated look with this palette. For example, today I'm actually wearing this bright pink and this softer pink in the crease. And then I deepen it up with this. And then I'm wearing a Menagerie Cosmetics single eyeshadow shimmer on the lid. And that's kind of like what I used this palette for this month. So I didn't get a chance to really focus on this one, to really do a look with just this one, but I did use it a lot in the end. I just love deepening up looks with the shades that are in this, just starting out the crease. There are just so many beautiful, colorful mattes, and I really enjoyed having this one in actually to be able to actually test out those shimmer eyeshadows. So yeah, I really enjoyed this one, but there were just so many other things that I had to try this month that it didn't really get the focus it deserved. But this is also one that I will probably put back in later on, and probably even when it's not in my Shop My Stash, I'm still gonna reach for this one because it's just so convenient. It just has so many colors that I like to use. So that was everything for my April Shop My Stash, and now let's get into my picks for March. So let's start with the lip products. First up, I'm putting in this lip product by Catrice. This is the Demi Matte Lipstick in the shade Pink Addiction. It's just a really bright pink. Probably I'm only gonna use this once, but this is just such a fun shade when it's really nice weather out. And I'm just looking forward to doing a look with a brighter lip, so that's why I chose this one. Then I also chose the Demi Matte Lipstick by Catrice in the shade Breathless Berry. This is kind of like a nude, but it has a really interesting kind of warm berry undertone. And I really enjoy that. I think this is just such a beautiful formula and such a beautiful color. It's just like a nude, but a little bit different, a little bit more special. Then I also chose this liquid lipstick by Sephora in its shade 57. And this is quite similar to the pink that I had in last time, but it's a little bit more cool tone, a little bit more bright. I can kind of use this as a more bright lipstick, but it's still like toned down enough for it to be wearable. So that's why I'm putting this one in. Then I also chose this ColourPop Ultra Satin Lip in a shade November. This is like a warm nude pink, leaning really warm, kind of rosy. It kind of has like a strawberry undertone maybe, and that's why I really love wearing it when it's a bit more like sunny out, when the weather is a bit better. And right now the Netherlands is like still in winter. I don't know what's happening. It's pretty cold, but next week it's gonna be more summery, and then I can't wait to wear lipsticks like this. Then last up, I also chose this ultra satin lip in the shade 951. This is kind of like a neutral nude liquid lipstick. It's just really wearable. I think this is gonna look good with a lot of different looks, so that's why I chose this one. Then next up, let's move on to the cheek products. At the start of my Shop My Stash, I actually told you that I didn't put in any bronzers because I just didn't have a lot of bronzers. I just had two. I didn't really need a Shop My Stash to really use my bronzers. But now I have a few more, I have like 4 or 5, and that's why I decided to actually put in a bronzer. This is the Skin Glazing, or the Skin Bronzing by Nabla in the shade Ambra. This is such a beautiful, shiny, glowy bronzer that isn't glittery at all. I really love wearing this one, but I've kind of like strayed away from this one. I haven't really used this for a few months because I was just really focusing on my Project Pan bronzer. And I just feel like I want to use this again. This is so good and I've really neglected it. So it's really time that I'm going to be using this again. And that's why I'm putting this in my Shop My Stash. Then I chose this Clinique blush in the shade Melon Pop. This is a really pretty kind of pinky peachy shade that is a bit bright, but when I apply it, it looks really natural. I really enjoy this shade. It's just so fun for spring, so that's why I'm putting this one in. Then I'm also putting in this blush by Kiko. This is from a limited edition from last year, from the Lost in Amalfi collection, and this is the shade Silky Sand. This is just a really beautiful baked blush that looks kind of neutral in the pan, but when I apply it, it looks kind of peachy, but it's not like too warm peachy that it looks like a stripe on my face. So it's kind of like a softer blush with a really pretty undertone, and I think this is gonna look good with more warm toned looks. Then I chose another Nabla Skin Glazing product. This is the Nabla Skin Glazing in the shade Independence. This is kind of like a mauve-y, glowy blush. And I haven't used this for quite some time. And it's about time I put this back in rotation. Then last up for the blushes, I always choose a lot of blushes because I'm just really into blush right now. And I just want to have some variation, I want to have some options. So yeah, I always choose a lot of blushes. So this is the Oil Infused Blush by Catrice in the shade Blooming Hibiscus. This is a beautiful corally shade that has a golden glow. And I think this is just so nice for warmer weather. So that's why I'm putting this one in. If you want to see my review on that blush, I actually put up a roundup review of New Essence and Catrice. So if you see any New Essence and Catrice here in my videos, then if you want to know my thoughts, that's in that video. One of the things that I also reviewed in this video is this Glow Glow Go liquid highlighter by Essence. I really love this one. It's such a nice liquid highlight. I usually use this one kind of like a base under other highlighters. It's just really pretty and I just don't want to forget to use this one, so that's why I'm putting this one in. Then I also chose this Give Me Glow Sunset Glow Late Night Coasting Highlighter. And this is kind of like a shimmery highlighter. It's like a champagne. It has quite a strong like duochrome. Like the base is quite on the dark side and then the sheen is quite light. I don't reach for this one a lot, but I do think it's really pretty. It's just a little bit outside of my comfort zone because it's a bit more shimmery. But I definitely want to get back into this one. Then last up for the highlighters, I chose another H&M highlighter. I have a lot of H&M highlighters and I really like them. I just really love this formula. So this is the highlighter in Delicate Pearl. It's kind of like a champagne with a peachy pink undertone, like a slight peachy pink undertone. It's really natural actually. And I just think this is a nice one just for every day, for more neutral looks, to combine this with that. It's just a really easy highlighter for me to wear because I just feel like it works with all different kinds of looks. Then let's move on to the eyeshadow palettes. First up, I chose this eyeshadow palette by ColourPop. This is the one from the tie-dye collection called Miss Bliss. This is kind of like a warm peachy palette with some pinks in there. I don't love this one, but if I'm ever gonna use it, then this is the time for it. So that's why I'm putting this one in. And I'm actually planning to combine this one with another palette that I didn't absolutely love. And that is the Artist Couture Ethereal Bloom. I really like the mattes in this one. I do think those are nice. The shimmers weren't my favorite. And I actually think I like some of the shimmers in Miss Bliss better. So I was thinking to kind of combine the two in one look and see how I like that. Then I'm also putting in the Saharan 2 by Juvia's Place. This one has such beautiful eyeshadows, such beautiful shimmers. But it's a little bit hard for me to wear because it's so pigmented. These mattes are a bit too deep and too warm for me. It's just not really wearable. But I was thinking I can just grab for these shimmers and then maybe combine it with some other eyeshadow palettes in my Shop My Stash. Even if I just take one or two of these for a look, then I would already be happy. I just don't want to be scared off from this palette and these beautiful shimmers just because I can't really use those mattes. So that's why I'm putting this one in. Then an eyeshadow palette that was in my Shop My Stash not too long ago, but I just feel like putting this in again. I just feel like doing more looks with this one, and that's the Side by Side Nude by Nabla. This just has all the nude options, and I just always want to put some neutral palette with some neutral options in my Shop My Stash, because sometimes I just want to go for a little bit more of a soft eye look, a little bit more neutral and wearable. So that's why I'm picking this one again. This is just my perfect neutral palette. And last up for the eyeshadows, I have this magnetic palette by ColourPop, but there aren't any ColourPop eyeshadows in here. I just have a bunch of random kind of like purple tone single eyeshadows. These are eyeshadows, these three from Glaminatrix. Those don't really count, but they're just in here for now. I'm still testing them, but it's about these purple, kind of like soft purple eyeshadows over here. I just want to go into the single eyeshadows a little bit more, because with some of my single eyeshadows, I just feel like I'm kind of neglecting them, and I just want to focus on this one a little bit more. So that was everything for my Shop My Stash. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like this video if you liked it, and don't forget to subscribe, and then I will see you in my next video. Bye bye!